I made this simple light dimmer for our smart light using ESP8266 and a Rotary encoder. This brings familiar manual control for our lights while keeping them connected to our home automation system. If we want to automate things and use fancy technology, there are countless different sensors and input devices that can be used to create more and more sophisticated home automation systems. While those are nice, sometimes it's good to have a basic manual control over our devices, no matter how smart they are. If you need to get PCBs for your version of this or other electronic circuits, you can order them from PCBWAY.com for as low as $5 for 10 pieces. Here are some examples of PCBWAY's PCBs and sample of their 3D printing service. For all your prototyping needs, go check out PCBWAY.com for up-to-date offering. In this demonstration, I have light configured in Home Assistant with entity ID light.which_bedroom. Once the light is working, REST is configured using ESPHome. In the YAML file, I have the default port configuration matching my port, as well as Wi-Fi, API and OTA configuration lines. The project-specific configuration is done under Sensor section. First, I have Rotary encoder sensor with values set to be in range from 0 to 100. Resolution depends on the actual Rotary encoder used. This tells how many pulses there are per one step. This can be either 1, 2 or 4. If a wrong value is set, one step may increase or decrease counted value by 2 or other way around. Two steps are required to change count by 1. Next, I have added filtering, mainly to limit the update rate to about 10 times per second. Rotary encoder sensor component in ESPHome will keep the correct count, but it will pass the value at a limited rate. Without this, something in the system would hang for a while if encoder was rotated too much too quickly. It doesn't really matter which pins are used for A and B, as long as they are configured as inputs and pull-ups are enabled either in configuration or in the hardware by adding actual resistors in the circuit. The On Value Automation section under the Rotary Encoder sensor is where the main logic is. When Rotary Encoder's counted value is changed, this will send Home Assistant service call to set the light with specific entity ID to the brightness matching the new value of the Rotary Encoder's count. Lambda indicates following is C++ code, and in these automations, variable X has the value that triggered the automation, Rotary encoder's new count in this case. One would think at this point this dimmer is ready. After all, rotating the encoder changes the brightness of the light. What is still missing is synchronization between Home Assistant's controls and this dimmer's controls. Changing brightness using Home Assistant at this point would not change the Rotary encoder's count, and thus, next time encoder is rotated, brightness will jump to where it was previously set using Rotary encoder, instead of changing just one step. Still in the sensor section, I've added new sensor using Home Assistant platform, with light's entity ID from Home Assistant. In this sensor's on value automation, I set Rotary encoder's count or value to match the brightness of the light. Brightness value has ranged from 0 to 255, and Rotary encoder is said to have range from 0 to 100. That's why the value is divided by 2.55. I have checked the logs, and at some point updating is skipped if the value is updated with the same value. That prevents this from going to infinite loop updating the Rotary encoder's count and light's brightness in the loop. It took me a few tries to get this working. I'm glad I managed to do this in one file and didn't need to split this between ESPHome and Home Assistant's automations. I hope this was helpful. Thanks for watching. Bye.